This is DM3, Yamaha's new series of compact digital mixing consoles that let you do more. In earlier videos, we've already explored all the input and output channel features and the internal effects. It's a truly professional offering for mixing live events, yet easy enough to use for occasional volunteers. Now, we're going to look at the two specific applications of recording and streaming. Can the same mixer also handle these tasks? Naturally and with ease. Both DM3 and DM3 Standard have two types of USB port, each of which can be used for audio recording and playback. One for stereo and one for multi-track. Firstly, the front panel connection. Insert a USB thumb drive for stereo playback and recording. Note that the drive needs to be formatted as FAT32, which is a common standard, though not always used by factory fresh drives. So, you can format a drive in the console. Open Setup and choose Save Load. Then swipe to open the screen menu and select Format. Once that's done, touch the tape icon at the top of the screen. In the Input-Output screen, select which pair of channels to record. Any output bus or indeed any direct input. Then choose the recording format. MP3 to reduce storage space, or up to 96 kHz 24-bit for the ultimate audio quality. And notice you have an independent recording level control in case you wish to boost or reduce the signal. When it comes to playback, the audio will go through the stereo in channel found in the effects mon fader layer. But you can easily change that. You can access all the transport controls here and on the title list, where you can browse through all the files in the drive. If you need to access these controls, often you can bookmark this page. Alternatively, set specific transport controls to the user-defined keys. Find the recorder functions, then transport, and then choose play, stop, next, record, and so on. Now let's talk about the rear panel USB port. This is to connect with a computer for multi-track recording and playback. There are drivers for Windows and Mac OS, and they provide 18 audio channels in and out at 48K or 96 kHz. So, by default, they are set to allow recording of inputs 1 to 16 and the stereo master. But you can freely change that in case you wish to record effects returns or any mix or matrix buses. This is perfect for recording a live performance or conference with each input tracked individually. Use it with any regular digital audio workstation software, such as the bundled Steinberg Cubase AI, or another version of Cubase or Nuendo you may already be using. Another use of the USB connection is for live streaming and even video meetings. Connect the mixer directly to the computer used for the streaming software such as Zoom, Vimeo, or YouTube. Select Yamaha DM3 as the audio source for the stream and assign a mix or matrix bus or the stereo master for that. DM3 includes some helpful scene presets for podcasting, recording session, and also a video meeting already set up with all the necessary audio routing to save you a good deal of time. When you want to play back a multi-track recording, like for a virtual sound check or a quick mixdown, open the Input Patch page from the Setup menu. Swipe left for the shortcuts, then All USB will quickly set each input for you. The USB port can also carry MIDI data, allowing the faders and switches of the console to control various functions within the compatible software. So you can use DM3 series as a hardware door controller for your projects when you're mixing in the box. It works well with Steinberg, Cubase, and Nuendo, for example. In Cubase or Nuendo, open the Studio Setup menu, select the Mackie Huey remote device, and assign DM3's USB port 2 for the connection. On the console, press both custom layer keys together to enter door mode. Now, the 8-channel faders, on, cue, and sell keys control the software. Channel names, level meters, and transport controls are shown on the screen. User-defined keys become transport controls, and next and previous keys for the channels and banks. It's so much faster and creative mixing with 8 faders rather than with 1 mouse. And is compact enough to use in a home studio. In fact, I'm hoping to take this one home myself. It's an excellent sounding audio interface and a convenient door controller all in one. With this mixer, you can create a great sound for live events, stream them, record them, and then remix them. That's why we say with DM3 series, you can do more. Join me again next time when I'll talk about Dante networking and how it can further expand the possibilities with DM3.